All right, thanks very much, Eric. Joined now by the House Republican Whip Eric Cantor, the number two Republican in the House of Representatives. He, among others, has expressed some concerns about the government's role in the GM bankruptcy, and he joins us now to talk about that and some other issues. Congressman Cantor, thank you for the time. Appreciate it. As I mentioned, you and some of your other colleagues there in the Republican leadership raising questions about the government's role in GM and in this bankruptcy. Would you have preferred an outright liquidation and the economic toll that would have caused across the country?
Well, Peter, I was one who very much thought that we ought to impose, sort of the existing law, if you will, on the situation surrounding the autos. In particular, we're now, as taxpayers, into GM probably about $70 billion. And the prospect for the taxpayers to make out in terms of GM and its profitability is very, very questionable. And, it's not just that Washington can begin to throw money at anything and everything and expect things to turn out okay. We've got to have some accountability here. So I'm troubled, Peter, by several things surrounding the GM situation. Number one, you've got investors who put some of their life savings into this company. And frankly, many of their rights have been trampled because the White House has come in and decided who was going to be the winner and who was going to be the loser. And if you see the UAW and how they came out in a much better stead than the individual bondholders and some of the secured bondholders, that's really not, I think, something that we believe that America should be about. When the White House comes in by fiat, suspends existing law, what is happening to the certainty of expectation when you're an investor? That's very, very troubling. But well, on down the road, Peter, it is about accountability. How are we going to go and account for all this?
Well, let me ask you about just the president's commitment that he doesn't want to operate this company on a day-to-day basis going forward. Do you take the president at his word?
Well, again, I mean, the reports that have come out surrounding the GM situation speak to the contrary. It says that the president spoke to the folks in the government around Detroit and have indicated the president has committed to ensuring that GM maintain its headquarters there. I think the president continues to say that all the big decisions are going to be made by GM itself. But come on, I mean, we're sitting here as Congress now telling GM what kind of cars it should make. We're sitting here directing the investment, if you will, of the kind of taxpayer dollars in favor of favored political constituencies. It is very hard to imagine that Congress and the White House will be able to stay out of the business of GM. Again, a very troubling sign.
Really quickly, Congressman, I want to get your take on this Hummer sale to a Chinese firm. They're members of Congress. Are they going to stand in the way of that?
Well, again, I think, Peter, you're going to have to expect that Congress is going to meddle in the management of anything having to do with GM at this point. I mean, the groundwork has been laid, and we're very, very concerned. And the government has no business running auto
companies. I've got to cut you short there. We're back here on Bloomberg after this short break.